Sing them over again to me, wonderful words of life. Let me more of their beauty see, wonderful words of life. Words of life and beauty, teach me faith and duty. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Christ the Blessed One gives to all wonderful words of life. Sinnerless to the loving call, wonderful words of life. All so freely given, wooing us to heaven. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Words of life and beauty, teach me faith and duty. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life. Beautiful words, wonderful words, wonderful words of life.
Welcome, beloved of God. Welcome to worship with First Christian Church in Burleson, Texas. If you will join me in our responsive call to worship. The heavens declare the glory of God. The skies reveal what God's hands have made. Day after day, they tell the story. Night after night, they tell it again. Without talking, without words, without their voices being heard. But God gave us eyes to see them and lips that we may tell. How great is God Almighty, who hath made all things well. Friends, let us observe a moment of silence as we call to our minds and hearts the joys and concerns, both public and private, that we bring with us to this worship service, proclaiming, "The Spirit of the Lord is with us." Let us go to God in prayer. God, we've gathered to praise you, to tell you once again that we adore you. We stand in awe at the beauty of your creation, delighting our senses and meeting our needs. We thank you for the countless ways you tenderly watch over us, like a loving mother or father watches over their precious baby. We know we break your heart when we sin, sin in what we do and say, sin in what we leave undone and unsaid. Forgive us, God, in your mercy. Pick us up and send us forth to try again. For the priceless gift of our salvation in Jesus, we will praise and thank you forever. For the gift of your own Spirit to live within us, to encourage and guide us breath by breath, we give thanks. God, we lay before you both the joy and the deep pain in our hearts. Be with all among us who grieve, who are lonely, angry, lost and confused, are weary in body and in spirit. Those who are sick and hurting, those who are afraid, and yes, God, those who have lost hope. Lord, you alone are sufficient to meet human need. Heal us now with your love and strength. Be with those who serve in these perilous times, risking their own safety for the sake of others. Bless them, God, and bless those who love them and worry about them. Guide our pastor and our elders. Give them wisdom and clarity and humility. Lord, protect our church. May we spread not illness, but the joy and peace of Christ. Give us your own patience when ours is exhausted. Keep on forming us in the image of Christ until we are kind as you are kind, forgiving as you are forgiving, generous as you are generous. Help us to be your hands and heart of healing and reconciliation in this broken nation, in this broken world. Until the day you call us home to heaven, hear our prayer, O Lord, in the words our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Good morning. This is the beginning of our 2021 stewardship campaign for next year's budget. What an appropriate time for our stewardship theme to be faithful, hopeful, loving. This year, 2020, has been a challenge from the word go. In March, when First Christian Church Burleson was interrupted, along with our learning center, shut down, COVID-19 came in as a challenge to everyone. Our minister, our congregation, our learning center, the general church operations. Our minister was challenged immediately, not knowing how our congregation would react to this situation. Can we hold the congregation together with services being suspended? How can I deliver my message if my congregation cannot attend services? Faith, hope, love. Our congregation was immediately faced with complete closure, with no idea when things would reopen or how long the lockdown would last. What will we do without our operations? Sunday services, Sunday school, church board, the cabinet, elders, stewardship, learning center, closed. Children staying home with working parents, and the loss of teachers' jobs. Another case for faith, hope, and love. With the leadership of our pastor and willingness of many volunteers, our services are being recorded in our sanctuary each Thursday afternoon for an online presentation for the weekend. And communion with prayer is made available in our Gregory Street parking lot each Sunday morning from 9 to 11. Faith, hope, love. By the grace of our Lord, our members have managed to stay faithful with their pledges for the current year, to remain well within our budget. However, in recent months, during these difficult times, our monthly income and participation is beginning to slide. It is commendable, though, for this small congregation to remain fairly stable. With the start of our 2021 stewardship drive, we feel it necessary to let everyone know exactly where we stand and make a plea to please prayerfully consider your tithes and offerings, pledges for the coming year. To not only maintain your current pledges, but to consider an increase for the coming year, if at all possible. We are so fortunate to meet the challenges of this very difficult time, but the challenges still remain for the future. If we maintain our faith, we will survive and continue to move forward to serve our community and the people that rely on this church. Everything is possible with God. A letter to our congregation is forthcoming next week. And with that letter, we will include the forms for your tithes and offerings, as well as your time and talents. A self-addressed envelope will be with this letter for you to complete your forms, put them in this letter, and send them back to the church. And we ask that you do this as soon as you can, so our church treasurer can put together the data for the stewardship committee to begin next year's budget. Should you have any questions or concerns, please feel free to contact us anytime. Remember, always maintain your faith. Never give up hope. And love your neighbor as you love yourself. Thank you.
Welcome to Children's Moment. Have you ever gone fishing? Have you ever caught a fish? Have you ever caught something other than a fish? Did you ever catch people? No? Well, guess what? Jesus did. Jesus was walking along the Sea of Galilee and decided he needed some helpers. Jesus saw two brothers, Simon, who Jesus called Peter, and Andrew. The brothers were fishing. Jesus said, "Follow me, and I will show you how to catch people." They left everything and followed Jesus. As they walked, they saw James and John. Jesus said to them also, "Follow me, and I will show you how to fish for people." They left everything and followed Jesus. Jesus called these helpers disciples. Jesus and disciples helped people who were sick and fed people who were hungry and told everyone the good news about God's kingdom. The disciples are showing us something called
Stewardship. Have you ever heard that word before? Stewardship. Stewardship means taking care of others. The disciples are showing us how to practice stewardship when they left everything behind to follow Jesus and help others. Jesus wants us to follow him just like the disciples did. Can you do that? I think we can. Will you pray with me? Dear God, thank you for people who teach us how to follow Jesus. Help us be helpers like the disciples and show us how to practice stewardship just like the disciples did. Amen.
Today's scripture is from the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 5, verses 14, 15, and 16. Hear now the word of our Lord. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. Thus ends the reading.
Let us pray. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Author, theologian, and former pastor of Riverside Church in New York City, the late Dr. William Sloan Coffin once said that if he attended a church on Sunday morning and discovered too late to get up and leave that the minister was going to preach a stewardship sermon, he would immediately bow his head and pray for brevity. I'll do my best to be brief. As you already know from Don Welch's stewardship moment, today we launch our annual stewardship campaign, and over the next several weeks we will focus on preparing each of you to consider how you will support the mission and ministries of First Christian Church for 2021 through the giving of your time and talents and financial resources. This is serious work, and I pray that you will take it seriously. That being said, I want to suggest, in response to Dr. Coffin's concerns about stewardship sermons, that the truth is every sermon is something of a stewardship sermon. If by that we mean the responsible and faithful management of everything we have and are, our money, our time, our deepest values and commitments, our very lives. Every sermon is a stewardship sermon if by that we mean counting our blessings, the gift of our lives, the gift of people to love, and above all else, the grace and love of God beneath and above it all. Every sermon is a stewardship sermon if we mean our joyful response to the good news of God's amazing grace. So this year, with our stewardship campaign theme of faithful, hopeful, loving, we begin the process of seriously planning for our future as each of us is asked to prayerfully consider our response to God, who calls us to be faithful stewards of all that He has entrusted to us. Typically, our stewardship campaigns focus on how we will share our time, our talents, and our financial resources in support of our work together to bring God's kingdom into its fullness and share the good news of Jesus Christ. But today, I want us to think about how we share another of God's gifts, the gift of light. The gift of light. In our scripture reading, we heard the words of Jesus, "You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid." And then he says, "Let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven." is a call to faithful Christian stewardship. Jesus is calling us to share the gift of God's light with the world. Those who first heard these words of Jesus were his disciples and others who gathered on a hillside. Jesus wasn't in the temple. He wasn't speaking to the Pharisees or the other religious leaders who were busy with their religious duties. No, Jesus wasn't speaking with those seeking out a religious experience at Mount Sinai. Jesus was speaking to men and women who were busy with their ordinary lives, just like us. Even more, Jesus told those folks that were gathered that they were light just as they were. They were light before they completely understood everything. Before Jesus had been raised from the dead, even before the Spirit had fallen upon the people at Pentecost, before all of that, Jesus proclaimed that the people assembled there were light. They didn't have to do an extra thing in order to be a light. They didn't have to pray more to be light. They didn't have to pledge more to be light. They didn't have to set aside more time to be light. Jesus said they were light. Now think about this. Jesus didn't tell them that they could be the light of the world if they wanted to. Jesus didn't give them an option. Sometimes God doesn't give us a choice. I mean, do you remember the story of Jonah? He didn't say, if you're interested, you can be light for the world. He said, you are the light of the world. Deal with it. Believing that Jesus was not only speaking to those on the hillside that day, but also speaking to us as believers and followers, then we too are light. We didn't start the light. We can't snuff it out. We can attempt to ignore the light, but that isn't what God wants us to do. We're meant to shine so that others can see clearly all that is around them, to see clearly God's manifold blessings, abundant provisions, joy and peace and love that transcends our circumstances. We are meant to shine so that others can see clearly the hope that can stare into the darkness and not be overcome by it. We are the light of the world. And what does light do? It shines. It doesn't have a choice. Light shines to reveal what is around it. Without light, we lack the ability to see things. We lack the ability to find things. Without light, we are stumbling around in the darkness. But we are not without light because Jesus tells those gathered that they are light. Again, this is not just about the disciples, you see. Jesus is still speaking to a crowd that includes disciples, but also includes people who had just stopped for a moment to hear him. Jesus is proclaiming that they are light. And as we hear his words today, he proclaims we too are light. We also hear in our scripture reading that Jesus encouraged the people to stop trying to hide their light. He said, no one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but puts it on the lampstand, and it gives light to all the house. So we are not to hide our light either, but rather to go ahead and let our light shine, to let our light shine to all the world. So what would happen? What would happen if we stopped trying to hide our light? What would happen if we really let our light shine? If we were to go ahead and let our light shine, one thing I think people would wonder about us would be, well, why are they so happy? Don't they see what is happening in our world? Don't they understand that things are not the way they should be? Don't they get the fact that people are suffering? And we can say yes to all of those things and yet still have a joy in our hearts that trusts that God is working all things out for the good of His people. Go ahead and let your light shine. If we were to go ahead and let our light shine, people might ask, well, why are they so hopeful? Don't they understand that we're on a road to disaster? Another financial crisis? Another unexpected medical bill? How can they be so hopeful? Don't they see the news? Don't they pay attention to the cries of people? Do they not care? And again, we can know that disaster is only one step away and still believe that this world is not bereft of God. God is within us and among us always. Let your light shine. If we were to go ahead and let our light shine, people might ask, why are they so peaceful? There are people out there who are wolves in sheep's clothing. They are robbing the poor. They are desecrating holy places. They are burning down cities. They are threatening people's safety and security with unchecked acts of violence and incivility. How can we be so peaceful? Again, we can see all of this and still believe that God has not abandoned us in this world without the resources to overcome evil with good. So go ahead. Let your light shine. If we were to let our light shine, people would observe our loving nature. And some might, in fact, be dumbfounded by it. Why are they so loving, they would ask. Don't they understand that they're being taken for a ride? These loving people seem so naive. How can they love people who are liars and slanderers, thieves and murderers? Yet we can know that we're being taken for a ride and still trust that God is going to use all things for His glory. So go ahead. Let your light shine. As Christians, we're called to witness to the good news of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We are called to let our light shine. And as members of the Christian Church, Disciples of Christ, we proclaim that we are a movement for wholeness in a fragmented world. How better to proclaim that than to let our light shine? And one of the ways we can let our light shine is to continue to support our ministries here at First Christian Church by responding generously with a commitment of our time, our talents, our financial resources during this stewardship campaign. God has richly blessed us. God has richly blessed each one of us. God has richly blessed all of us. And now it's up to us to determine how brightly God's light will shine through First Christian Church in 2021. Thank you Thank you for walking alongside me as we journey together. I look forward to a bright 2021 as we let our light shine. Amen. It's at this time in our worship when we pause to recognize and reflect on the bounty of blessings and gifts that God has continues to pour into our lives. We again affirm that all that we have, all that we are, has come from God. And through Scripture, we are reminded that we are called to share out of our abundance, to be good stewards, but to share out of what has been given and entrusted to us to benefit those who are less fortunate. And so at this time, we again take this moment to practice the discipline of Christian stewardship. For God has shown us the meaning of generosity and the beautiful diversity of His creation. In the overflowing love of Jesus Christ, and in the never-ending gift of the Holy Spirit, God has abundantly blessed us and called us to be a community that blesses others through the sharing of our love and our talents and our material possessions. And so again today, let us rejoice in what we have been given and in what is ours to give as we bring forth our tithes and our offerings. Let us pray. Dear God, receive the gifts of our hands and our hearts that are offered for your service. In the name of the risen Christ. Amen.
Of course, in the Disciples denomination, and certainly here in our church, First Christian Church of Burleson, worship would not be complete if we didn't celebrate Holy Communion together. Hopefully, in the not too distant future, we can do that as one body together right here in this sanctuary. Until then, we are still one body, but we can celebrate communion at our homes or whatever online. Remember that if you would like, that you can come to the front parking lot and receive communion on Sunday mornings between 9 and 11, if you would like to do that also. Last week, I reminded you of a favorite scripture of most everyone. It was John 3:16, and it spoke of everlasting life. Last night, I thought of an Old Testament scripture that is probably a favorite of most everyone also, and it speaks of eternal life. The 23rd Psalm, in such a beautiful way, states, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." And then it goes on to continue and let us know of the comfort that we can find through in our lives as we continue our walk with God. It goes on to assure us that with our faith, we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Jesus, in his time with the disciples in the upper room, let them know that they, and we too, have the same promise of eternal life. God's love for us never changes, and God proved that by allowing his Son to die on the cross for the forgiveness of our sins so many years ago. So now, we celebrate Jesus' Last Supper with His disciples as He requested, and we join together in remembering Him. May we pray. Dear Lord, we ask Your blessing on this cup and on this bread, and as we partake of it, we remember the sacrifice that Jesus made. We remember what these emblems stand for, and we share them together with other members of our community. Amen. The Lord Jesus, on the night that he was betrayed, took bread. And when he blessed it and gave thanks, he said, "This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." May I invite you to join with me as we partake of the bread, the body of Jesus. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me." And may I invite you to partake of the cup with me at this time. Each time we come together to worship, we eat this bread and we drink of this cup as Jesus requested, and we proclaim the Lord's death and celebrate our invitation to eternal life. May we pray. Dear Lord, we do remember Jesus' sacrifice. We give thanks that through this sacrifice, we have a pathway to everlasting life. Once again, we honor you with this special celebration, and we give you all the praise. Amen.
I invite you to join with me now as we receive a benediction. Go in peace. Love and care for one another in the name of Christ. And may God lead us to places of rest and renewal. May Jesus Christ give us life in abundance, and may the Holy Spirit fill our hearts with gladness and generosity, both now and always. Amen.